5 awesome movies where the whole gang gets back together, available on Now TV. Okay, the Muppets, one of the most famous gangs in TV and movies, but apparently they disbanded sometime in the 90s. They're still in syndication though, because Jason Segel and his brother Walter are big fans. So big that they decide to leave small town and go to the big city to see the studios. They bring along Amy Adams, and then they promptly forget about her. The studios turn out to be dilapidated, under threat from big oil, because the main concern for oil men is minor tourist attractions featuring puppets.
I think they're so funny.
This is the perfect excuse to find Kermit and the gang and get them to hold a telethon to save it, which is lucky, because otherwise...
This is going to be a really short movie.
They find Kermit here, which makes me think that he keeps all that rerun money, because the rest of the Muppets are in pretty dire straits. Anyway, they only have 2 days to find everyone, clean up the studio, secure TV time.
You've got yourselves a show.
And create a lineup, which will make people donate. So you'd think they want to hurry, but they still take every opportunity to sing and dance. Which makes for a great movie. They also kidnap Jack Black, which is kind of illegal. And so is trying to steal a Fabergé egg worth $1 billion. But in this movie, it's kind of okay, because they look so good doing it.
Yeah.
In Ocean's 12, they're trying to pay back Andy Garcia after stealing from him in Ocean's 11. There aren't really 12 of them, because the old guy stays behind, this guy becomes lost luggage, Bernie Mac gets arrested. And at one point, there's just 3 of them, none of whom are George Clooney, who plays Danny Ocean. So it's really more like the Matt Damon 3. But there are 2 Julia Roberts, which for some people is too many.
It's just wrong!
But it doesn't really matter, because they're all being played by this rich French guy who outsmarts them with some pretty awesome yoga breakdancing, which he quite possibly invented. Also featured in this movie, Brad Pitt eating all the time, Catherine Zeta in a good wig, and Don Cheadle in a bad accent.
Without us, it don't leave your head, mate.
There's also a little trouble with accents in The Hangover 2.
Do you understand a word he just said?
But really, the Wolfpack should be more concerned at the fact that they're in the same plot as the first Hangover, except it's a different groom, a different city, and the plan is to have a different kind of bachelor party.
This is the bachelor party.
What are you talking about?
But they brought the same Galifianakis, so when Stu says,
I'll see you in 20 minutes.
You know that's not gonna happen. Instead, we embark on some epic deja vu, which starts with a bad haircut, a really bad tattoo, someone gone missing, and a monkey.
It's a monkey!
Now, I'm not gonna tell you what happens at the end, but I will say that this time, they do check the roof. Although the real lesson here is that when one of these guys gets married, there's going to be trouble. And when these guys get together, there's going to be magic. And in Deathly Hallows Part 2, there is a lot of it. There's loads of rollercoaster broomsticking dragon riding action, although you kind of wonder why no one in London noticed this in the sky. Harry, Ron, and Hermione basically cause Armageddon while taking on this dude, this snake, this army, and this guy whose name you definitely should not say. It's a classic tale of good against evil, but with the war taking place at Hogwarts, which, when you think about it, is technically just a high school, which means their high school reunion is going to be awkward.
That's unfortunate.
Speaking of reunions, here's an American one, where the gang from Great Falls are all grown up and struggling with life a little.
Guess the party's over.
Even though they have girlfriends way out of their league and hot 18-year-olds heart them, it's tough. Because they have responsibilities now. Like, these guys are parents, he's on TV, he's a housewife, he has a bike, and Stifler, well, he's as awesome as ever. I can't give away too many details because it's pretty raunchy stuff, but pivotal plot points include the return of Tara Reid, Stifler's revenge.
Are you ready for me, Stifler?
And Shannon Elizabeth keeps her clothes on this time, which you think would have hurt ticket sales, but American Reunion did mega box office, even though they were celebrating their 13th year high school reunion, which I actually don't think is a thing.
Great movie.
Which just goes to show that it doesn't matter if you're battling big oil, or fighting dragons, or breaking laws in foreign countries, or just celebrating odd-numbered anniversaries, to get gangs this good back together, any excuse will do. You can catch all 5 of these movies in our Great Gangs collection, available on Now TV.